Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Oh my god!
No, no! Shut it down, no!
Hold on!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god!
Hey, welcome back, everybody. One-Eyed Sniper here. All right, we are still trying to skip the vault. We've got Nick Valentine with us. I was saying his name wrong, I think. I was calling him Vincent in the last few episodes. I'm not sure why. Also, in the last episode I recorded using Shadowplay, I talked about that. Turns out that doesn't work for me. So hopefully you don't notice. I think I fixed it. But basically, Shadowplay records in a variable frame rate, and my video editor won't take it. So what happens is the audio ended up being out of sync, so I had to run it through Handbrake to make it a constant frame rate. Anyways, so basically I had to roll back my driver, and now I'm back using OBS. Till that gets fixed, I guess. So, killed a lot of people, and we're on our way out of here. Hopefully we make it out soon. Nick's still unarmed as well. Let's take this opportunity to save. We're getting a lot of 45 ammo here, which is pretty awesome. Though our 45, our combat rifle, I think is what it's called, is kind of lacking, so we need to modify that a little bit. I always liked paintings of boats for some reason. Though I generally like it when it's more like rough seas kind of thing, but a lot of good stuff in here, huh?
Well, if anyone could figure out a good use for it.
Alright, we're not getting in there. I am going to take this tuxedo, because why not? I have no idea if we'll ever have a time to wear it. Is your personality in charisma? I know if there's a armor mod I can take where you could actually add armor to stuff like this. I'd have to look at it. It's probably Armorsmith Extended, I imagine. Which is compatible, I just never looked at it. Maybe I should do that. Wouldn't mind running around in a tuxedo. Tuxedo and a fedora. How much these submachine guns are worth? Not bad, actually. It's worth more than the hunting rifle, though it weighs... Nah, I guess not. Hunting rifle 63. It's 109, but the hunting rifle weighs half. What it weighs.
Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard.
Alright, so we're gonna have some kind of like boss battle-ish. So I'm gonna get our 308 rifle ready.
But I hear big fat footsteps on the other side. Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
Big fat footstep. You gonna open it or I have to go up there? Oh, okay, it's gonna be a loading screen. Well, that's great. We should be prepared to take some jet, I guess. And I'll try to cap some fools. Let's see if this terminal's got anything new going on. It does. Okay, please remind residents to line up in orderly fashion. Change into vault seats immediately. Save all questions for orientation. Yeah, that's what they told us. Okay, the Linehan family, Sean. Blah, blah, blah. It's just gonna give a description of family members. Dog Spike, do not allow. That's fucked up. Todd Gates, bachelor. Huh. All right. Nothing overly interesting. Alright, let's do this. Let's see what kind of trouble we run into. See who was making these big fat footsteps.
Nicky, what are you doing? You come into my house, shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just run back home to Daddy, shall I?
Should have left it alone, Nicky. This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle, you hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should have just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Darla, I'm handling this. Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
This is not good.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this guy doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought him here to rub us all out.
Alright, see if I can talk my way out of that. This. Because they've got submachine guns, and I'm really close. I'm not exactly thrilled with our odds here. So let's go with Remember the Quarry.
Wait, Skinny. Remember the Quarry. Lily June on the rocks? Ring any bells?
How the hell did you know about that? Okay, you two can go. You got until the count of 10. Then I don't care what happened back in the old days.
Oh, that we learned that earlier.
What are you doing, Skinny? Kill him!
No, Darla. They get one chance to leave. Skinny Malone's putting his foot down.
My mother was right. You mobsters are all just talk.
We better get out of here, fast.
One.
Okay, let's go.
Two. Some man Skinny Malone turned out to be. I'm going home to my parents.
I feel... I kind of feel like killing him. Let's see if we get the drop on them. They come after us. Where are they shooting at?
Shadows now? There's nothing here.
Yeah, I'm an a-hole. I am not gonna walk away from this. But we talked to a trigger man a while ago, and he gave us, like, something to do, but I don't know if that was the code he gave us, or what. Okay, well, we're gonna... Damn it, saw me. I don't think we have any mines, do we? No. Take that, mob boss. Really? You guys are just gonna stand there? That seems a little cheap on my part. Oh well.
Shouldn't hide. Ain't very courageous of you.
Why can't they I don't know why they couldn't see me. Oh, Piper got stayed here. They shot her. Well, I don't feel so bad. Oh, well, that was all kind of lame. I was expecting something a little... better? Nick stayed back. He didn't have anything on him. Probably really wasn't worth the ammo, actually. Alright, let me drop that 10mm pistol. So let's see if I still have that quest. We were supposed to go... Oh yeah, I don't remember which one it was. Let me see if it was one of the miscellaneous. We met him at that train station. I don't know. Maybe he just put us something on our map, but I could swear he gave us a like a code word to say or whatever. It's possible that it's this one, but I don't think so. Anyways. Water. I don't know where Nick went. He must have ran out of here. And is Piper coming or what? Yeah, there she is. Alright, we should just be able to run out of here ourselves. I wonder if we're gonna have to follow him all the way back to his office or not. Where is he at? Make sure I got the... For sure I have the quest turned on. I don't. But he's waiting right outside though, apparently. Alright, he's still not here. He must have went all the way back to his office. I sure as hell don't see him. Continue following the Freedom Trail. What is it talking about? I wonder if the Nick...
Welcome, Patriot, to Boston Common. The start of the... Freedom Trail. Feast your ears and learn more about the history.
I don't have time, robot. Well, I guess I could. Nick's... whatever. We'll do it. Nick can wait.
Welcome, Patriot, to Boston Common, the start of the Freedom Trail.
Okay, at Journey's End, follow Freedom's Lantern.
Tell me about the Freedom Trail.
Starting here at Boston Common. Follow the red path as it winds its way through our great city's streets. Markers on the trail are placed at many famous historic sites. See Paul Revere's house, the Old North Church, the Old State House, Bunker Hill, and many more.
Okay. Let's see. We're kind of full up on our inventory space. I guess I could always call another robot. What was I gonna do? Oh. Alright, we'll turn that one on. Let's see if we can follow it. Oh, this one, the red path. Okay, so we're gonna go this way. Kind of the opposite direction that we were going. There's a rad storm coming. Yay. Or am I not following the right thing, or is this just being annoying? Got a seminary. Oh, cemetery with ghouls. That figures. All right.
Guess we showed them.
He just kind of snapped in half.
It hadn't come to that.
Oh, we're gonna need to get somewhere though. I don't want to take on a bunch of rads. in the storm. Is there any houses nearby? Especially if they end up bringing more mutants, that would be bad. Come on. Or not mutants, ghouls. Good job, dog meat.
This is normal for other journalists. I can carry something if you need me to.
I don't need you to. Right now, I don't think you can carry anything either. Franklin. Is this supposed to be Benjamin Franklin? Which case it's fitting, since we're in the middle of a storm.
Two and A.
Two A. Okay, I don't quite get it yet, but... I could sit down here, right? No. No, these aren't sittable. It's not adding a bunch of rads, but it is adding rads. Let's see. It's going through that pile of crap. Oh shit, what am I doing? Wandering through super mutant camps. This isn't gonna kill him with a headshot, but I don't want to use any more of our 308 ammo. Skirmisher will be melee, right? So I should be able to... see if he's got any buddies in here. I don't see any, so let's see if we can just get a couple headshots on him. Alright, I must have hit something else that wasn't him. Got the kill. Alright, nice.
A noise?
Oh, he had a gun on him, actually. Shit. Oh, these guys are actually kind of weak. Compared to the Triggermen. Oh, did it pass? Okay, we got a normal storm now. That's good. Unless it gets really foggy. Or a dust storm, which... alright, that's shitty. Shotgun shells are always welcome. Nothing else good. 38 rounds. It's gonna be kind of hard following this trail in a sandstorm, but we'll make do. Though I could always knock that body out of the chair and wait it out, which I may just do that. Sandstorms are pretty cool and atmospheric and all, but they're kind of... they're not very conducive to a Let's Play, to be honest with you. Unless it passed already. This isn't that Trinity Tower, right? And no. It's not. Okay, the weather here is on a little bit on the crazy side. Rad storm pops up and then goes away pretty quick. Sandstorm goes away and now nothing. There are.
For now.
Let's get the high ground here. But that did not help us. Yeah, I don't think so. Alright, I'm gonna have to go down.
Is that it?
Can't turn those off. I don't know why I even tried. Took that headshot pretty well. Ow. Oh, this guy's taking some hits. Alright, now, that's done. That guy must have had some armor on or something. I wouldn't say it went better than expected. I got shot a lot. Anyways, let's go up, and then we'll head outside. It didn't look like this building was that big. Just in case someone's on the roof, I guess I should stay, or whatever's left of the roof. Better stay hidden. Where's all this heading to? I would assume more super mutants. Or gunners. Mass fusion plant. Or building, or whatever it is. That's creepy. Alright, but let's head out back to where those, super mutants were. We'll loot them. And I think we'll keep trying to follow the Freedom Trail, unless it's running into a lot of people we don't want to mess with. I do, at that. Alright, so this is just out behind the building. Which I don't want to go, so I want to keep following that trail. Which we kind of lost in the rubble, but... there's a building there, so it has to just be going down the street. It may actually run us into these gunners. Kind of sucky. We'll see, maybe it'll take a right. It is. Okay, we're gonna go around them. Good neighbor. Is it running through good neighbor? No, there's a lot of dead people out here, though.
Now a 6 and an O.
I forgot the other numbers already. Like, I don't know. Hopefully our character's remembering them. Is this... guess this is a city. I wouldn't mind selling some stuff. Kind of weird to see dead people right outside of it, but I guess that's not all that rare, given the situation. Dogmeat found an enemy. Inside? Or maybe not. What do you got, boy? Where's it at? Can you walk faster? Oh! There it is. Alright, let's see if we can't sneak up on it. He's gonna have more than one. No, don't go in there.
What was that?
It was me shooting a mongrel dog. Anyone else? Thought I just saw a massive shadow for a second. Where's the dog I just killed? There he is. I'm gonna check out Good Neighbor. I'm pretty sure it's a city. But... could be a terrible trap. Who knows? We'll sneak in.
Hey, hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
Uh-huh.
Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn? I said let him go.
You soft, Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something.
Kind of saw that coming.
Say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. You all right, brother?
I still don't trust you.
You killed him.
Got a good pair of eyes on you. I think you'll fit in here. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Good neighbor? That what you call this place?
That's right. We cobbled this little neighborhood together out of the freaks and misfits that just wouldn't be accepted anywhere else. You'll see. You make enough friends here, you'll call this place home soon enough. So long as you remember who's in charge.
Yeah, this place is shady, but kind of could have figured that, I guess. Just from the name, but there is a store here. We can sell some stuff. Looks like it's got a badass robot as a vendor.
A new player in Good Neighbor. Hello, little pawn. Welcome to our fun and games. You ever tried chess? Sometimes you need to sacrifice a piece to keep the game going. Keep that in mind.
Guys, this is some deep stuff going on here that I probably want to get into later. But I wouldn't mind, like I said, selling some stuff. It's a cool power armor station.
Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Okay.
Who... what are you?
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Oh, of course you are. It's just... all those metal plates. You're a robot, right? A very womanly... robot?
Designation, Assaultron. Designed to provide a variety of security-related tasks to the modern man. Runtime conclusion. Why work for the man when you can work for yourself? New designation. K-L-E-O. Cleo. Fully independent small business owner. Robot enough for you, smooth talker? Now what are you buying?
Assaultron. Yeah, I don't know much about them.
You're... an Assaultron?
That's what my makers called me. But as far as I'm concerned, I'm a woman. And I run a store that sells very large guns. So what'll it be?
So what kind of weapons do you have?
Anything that can kill a man, I sell. Except suicidal depression. That is unfortunately not packageable. Now, are we doing business?
Okay, yeah, enough questions. Let's see what you got.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Murder and mayhem at a discount.
Alright, I don't know how much we actually have to sell. Hunting rifle was one. It's that bad boy. Was I going to sell this? Yeah, I was. Okay. Oh, you can have the Sexito. Alright, let's cancel it. Let's also see what I put on Piper here and dog meat.
Hey.
What can I do?
Sell that. That. I want her to equip that. I don't know why she never does. It might be because she doesn't have any ammo. She's just resorting to her thing. And if that's the case, then... Actually, yeah, I'm just gonna sell that too. Alright, what about you, dog meat? What do you have?
Hey.
You don't really have anything. Which makes sense. Let me give you these rest of these 45 rounds. Okay.
Cleo.
Alright, Cleo, let's see.
I hope you're buying. Even a girl with an arsenal full of weapons needs to make a living after all.
Let's see what you got.
Let's get you outfitted, killer.
Okay, let me finish selling this. Oh, I need to sell this heavy stuff I just picked up. That. That. Alright, we're gonna need to buy some ammo, I think. Temporarily slows time during combat when you're at 20% or less health. That'd be pretty awesome. It costs 7,354. Yeah. Was it this one? Yeah, okay. Power armor frame, that's kind of cool. Alright, let's buy all the 308 rounds. Good chunk of change right there, just 10 rounds. Missiles are expensive. Let's see. I'll make sure I'm not selling something I need. I don't think we are. Go and... This stuff's worth a decent amount. And I think I picked up some junk food I want to get rid of that I always forget. So let's dump that now. It's just taking up space. See, bubblegum, gumdrop. Looks like it. He doesn't have any junk, right? Okay. There we go. Alright, I should look at what weapons he has.
Could be the difference.
Let's see what you got.
Let's get you outfit.
Right.
And actually look at that. Chinese officer sword. So ours is better. Knuckles, machete. That's 51 damage. 44. Alright. Okay, about 10 mils. Party starter does 20% more damage against human. Rocket launcher. And it doesn't really have anything too special. I wouldn't mind these knuckles if we could mod it in any kind of way. Which is the sword weigh? 3 pounds? I'm gonna buy them just so we can keep them on us, and I'll see what I can do with it.
Been talk about Vault 81. Some problem there you were caught up in? Quarantine or some such? Damn, you've been around.
Thank you.
Oh, a new face walks into my store. And you're not even screaming yet. Very polite. You let me know if anything catches your fancy.
Did you say something about people screaming at you?
That's right. Some newcomers have never seen a ghoul before. Can't handle a friendly face, I say. So you need some supplies?
What's it like, you know, being a ghoul?
Well, it's a lot worse when people always ask you about it all the time. But I guess I can't blame them. On the upside, I look pretty good, for being over 220 years old. Now, were you buying anything?
Let's ask about your age first, Daisy.
Wait, you're 220 years old?
Okay, it's more like 270 years. But don't go blabbing that to everyone. Being a ghoul means you live a long time. You stop counting birthdays. Do you know what it's like being that old?
Kind of.
What's it like?
It's like being in a time warp sometimes. Hundreds of years between you and the 20-somethings running around here. Not that you'd know what that's like, would you?
Actually, I do.
Well, now you're just making fun of me. If you were as old as I was, you would have been around since before the war. So let's hear it. Come on. Tell me what the world was like before the war, if you're so ancient.
Okay. It wasn't really... Well, it was beautiful and peaceful once, and then I guess it was violent and ugly. I'm gonna... Same as always. Let's go same as always.
It was pretty much what we have now. Just with less rust.
Yeah, that's true, isn't it? Well, you're either the most well-preserved ghoul I've ever seen, or you're the second-best bullshitter and good neighbor.
So, what do you remember about the past?
Oh, sweetie, I was an angry young woman back then. Thought the world was sick and wouldn't give me my due. Then it all ended, and well, I ended in a way, becoming a ghoul. Maybe when you get to be my age, everything starts to look like fate. Anyway, I like your story better, whether or not it's true.
It's the truth. All of it.
You know, if you haven't already, you should check out the Hotel Rexford. There's another pre-war ghoul hanging around there. Well, we should get back to business. What are you picking up?
What kind of things do you sell?
Oh, a bit of everything. Canned beans to Kim. I try to take every weird bit of junk the caravans are willing to trade. So chances are you'll find something to your liking here. Ready to take a look?
Almost. I want to see if she has any duct tape and stuff. Let's see if she's got any work.
Got any work?
I do, actually. Super mutants have taken over the old Boston Public Library. I got a lot of fond memories of that place from when I was a girl and human. You get those lumbering brutes out of there? I'll pay you 200 caps.
It's already done. I'm gonna ask for money. More money.
I don't think that's enough money to cover clearing out a whole building.
You got a good point. We'll make it 250 caps.
Okay, now I already did it.
Actually, I already took care of those super mutants.
You did? Huh. Now that's service for you. Here's your money. Oh, and why don't you take this old book of mine? Been holding on to it for a while, if you ever happen to go back there.
Got an overdue book. All right, sweet. Well, that was an easy quest.
Hey, Daisy.
Let's see what she's got for sale.
That you made the library a safer place. Thanks.
I'll take a look. Sure.
All the supplies, money, or violence can buy.
All right. So she's got a couple pieces here. Destroyer's chest, reduce damage from humans by 15%. It's not bad. It has no radiation coverage, but weighs 9.5. What are we wearing? Eight, so it weighs a little more, but it's slightly better, and you get the 15% damage from humans, which is what we're facing most often. It's only 1,099. I can afford it. Okay, we just sold that to somebody else. I don't want any food. But let's see what she's got here that we want. I'm just going to buy any adhesive. Because she only had one thing of adhesive. So, and it was expensive adhesive. I think I'm going to buy this destroyer's chest. And we will sell what? Yeah, the combat armor, that's only going to get us 30. I'm not going to sell it then. We'll keep it and see what we can do to it. See what this looks like. Yeah, just got a star on it, I guess. Nothing special. Alright, let's give you this, I'll hold on to that chest piece. Alright, let's get out of here. What we're gonna do is end the episode here. And then, yeah, we'll pick back up following that Freedom Trail in the next episode. I will come here and check this place out a little greater, amount some other time. But it feels like there might be a lot going on here, so I don't wanna get anything too deep without finishing Nick's quest. I don't know if this place is going to be different the next time we show up, because that guy did mention that we're good to go in. Like, we shouldn't be bothered at least the first time. Alright, before I exit, we're going to find out what the hell that is.
Oh, that's how it's done, boys.
I think some raiders just killed someone. Alright, it doesn't look like they're after us, so I will still go and end here, and then maybe we'll find out what that is in the next episode. I think I'll walk around the building and check it out. Go Red Stag, Red Roach, and some chunks here. Here we go. But alright guys, that's going to end it for this one. I know I have a choice to rewatch or follow Let's Plays, and I thank you for choosing One-Eyed Sniper. Peace out, everyone.